What is going on, everyone? My name is Boyd, and I am back with some more Age of Mythology, the Titans action. Spawning in the top of the map in the blue color, playing as Isis, is from the DoD clan. His name is Joe. His opponent today in the red color, playing as Thor, also from the DoD clan. His name is Brickhead. The map is Tundra. This is the semi-final of the RTS Sanctuary Christmas Tournament, best of five. And it is currently 1-1. Brickhead on one. Won the really cheesy strategy game on Midgard where Joe decided to try and go for an Ancestor's Eclipse timing push on the land. Way too obvious, and Brickhead managed to defend against that. And then Joe won the first game on Mediterranean with some solid play against Brickhead's Ragnarok, Fast Ragnarok. Okay, what are we going to see in this game? Isis versus Thor still. Brickhead still confident in his Thor against the Isis. We're probably going to see on this map with so much hunt, we're probably going to see some classical age shenanigans from Joe. Joe loves his Anubites. Anubites are such a difficult unit to deal with as Norse. You need to pull together Hearse on every single one of your resources so that they can't just jump in and kill them all. So you can just leave them kind of on a defensive stance, maybe passive stance, right next to your villages so that when the Anubite jumps in, they take damage. So every time they jump in, they need to take damage so they can't actually kill the villagers, and every time they jump, they're going to be getting closer and closer to death so that eventually you kill off the Anubites without losing any villagers. That's the plan for a Norse player, but it's so difficult to do, and Joe's got great control of his Anubites. He's going to do that very, very well. On the other hand, Brickhead can go Forseti. If he goes Forseti, he can chase the Anubites around and actually kill them. I think they're similar speeds, so the Hall of Thane's Herso do very, very well. Also, it's a great counter to Plague of Serpents and Ancestors, or it's a great counter to Ancestors Eclipse if Joe decides to go for a fast heroic play here. The next option would possibly be Joe deciding to go for a two-town center classical play, but I don't think he normally does that. I haven't seen a lot of him going two-town centers, and I actually just don't think it's that strong in 1v1. I think it's a little bit too slow, and your opponent can do a little bit too much damage to you. That being said, if you can defend very, very well, it is always great to get that second town center early. But your opponent can simply just go for fast mythic ages and deal incredible amounts of damage. So let's talk about the gold on the map. We've got a very nice gold man back here. If you can chuck a temple here and then a house or two, that's completely shut in. Or you can just wall this off as well. I think that would be totally fine. We are seeing that the Ulfsark has spotted a obelisk here. It's going to go down. It's a nice win there for Brickhead. Brickhead gets a couple of free favor there, which is nice. Anyways, gold, safe gold mine here. It's pretty close second gold mine over here, but it's not exactly defended. You've got a town center that Brickhead can sneak past and pick that location off. There's this gold mine here and this gold mine here, which also not that well defended. So the second gold mine's for Joe, going to be difficult to grab there. It's the same sort of situation there for Brickhead as well. He's got this gold mine here and this gold mine over here. Not too great, so you can get some very, very strong timing pushes in order to win this game. And we're going to have to see if they can execute basically on that is probably going to be the game deciding factor. But we'll see. Potentially, Brickhead's got the option to go for his Ragnarok play. So he could go for that early second town center, jump straight to the Mythic Age, and then go Ragnarok, Flaming Weapons in an attempt to gold starve is an option. We'll see if he does choose to do that or not. We do have our little obelisk here, so Joe's gonna know about this. Very strong play that Egyptians used to do, maybe can still do, especially Set. Isis can do it as well. Is you go for a very fast advance time, about the 4 minutes and 30 seconds advancing to the classical age, and getting priests and pharaoh out to go forward, and then you send your Anubite as well with them, and you can basically push off hunt at the 4 minutes and 30 seconds mark. But Joe definitely not going for that one, definitely staying in that classical age a little bit longer, grabbing that second monument. Definitely going to be seeing Anubis in this game. Anubis is super strong now. We do see that there's blue crystal shard as well, 5% villager wood and gold gather rate. Very, very good relic. Basically make sure gold, it's a half a pickaxe. It's essentially half a pickaxe and half a hand axe. Super good. One of the best relics in the game. What other relics are on the map? We just see Kofesh of Horus, which is great for, basically great for the Norse player, Brickhead. So Brickhead wants to be grabbing that one. And I think that is it. Has he seen it though? He has seen it and he should be thinking about grabbing that one. He has got that grab there and he is going through Freya. So no Forseti. He can use his Valkyrie to shut down Anubites as well though. So need to be careful with his Valkyrie and want to keep that guy alive. That being said, Troll is just as good. If you sit him on a location, he throws his little pebbles at the Anubites and chips away, which is generally the strat you want to be going for. We are seeing Anubis is coming for Joe. So Joe opting for his standard strategy here. I don't think they've played a land map matchup yet, so they're still trying to feel each other out and see what is going to be great to be using for each other to see how this works out. We are seeing Freya coming through there for Brickhead. Bunch of houses getting deleted there for some reason. We jump back over to Brickhead's perspective. He's grabbing that longhouse. He's not producing, or he's producing some more Hursa. So longhouse is coming out. However, no second early second town center just yet. So being a little bit safe there by grabbing these two longhouses, potentially just going to be playing standard and going for a semi-fast heroic flaming weapons timing push on the gold mines. If we check out what he's seen, he hasn't actually seen the back gold mine just yet. He has basically seen every gold mine on the map except for this one over here. And he still has his, oh, I didn't notice that. He still has his dwarven mine. So he didn't use dwarven mine straight away. So he's lost a little bit of economy on the early game. However, his placement of here is very, very good. So he saved a little bit of economy there on the ox cart from the early game. So he's going to be able to save this gold mine and sit in his base for even longer. We are seeing this Ulfsark. Looks like it's going to get a bunch of damage there. It's going to be able to survive and get rehealed by the Valkyrie if Brickhead chooses to do so. Brickhead has spotted this food gathering location for Joe, but Joe's finished with that one. He's going to be moving back, and we see these Anubites coming out now. So I feel like these two Anubites are going to be more than enough to make this Valkyrie want to get back to home. And he's also going to be taking a bunch of damage from that watchtower. Both of those watchtowers as well. And we are seeing, oh, a nice little spot there for Brickhead. Brickhead going to be moving in here, attempting to stop this location. We're seeing Forest Fire get cast as well. I'm not sure about that Forest Fire. It's going to be able to keep that Valkyrie to be kept alive. The Priest is going to be taking a bunch of damage there now, and some more units following in here. But this town center looks like it's probably going to get up. Ooh, maybe get up. We are seeing this Valkyrie moving back in. The Priest going to get picked off as well. Those Plague Servants do absolute work there. And looks like this, oh, Anubite going to be falling there, which is huge there for Brickhead. Brickhead just desperately trying to keep this town center from going up. Needs to pick off a couple more of these villages as well. These villages are next to no HP as well. Seeing a bunch more villages move into this location. This is a bunch of damage now done. Brickhead has definitely come out with a win there. He has picked off a bunch of what Joe has got, a bunch of villages lost there. Though a little bit of army has fallen and the town center's up now. So basically Brickhead knows he's got a little bit of time to work with. Joe's got to basically start pumping villages and he's not going to be able to do all too much army-wise. He does have the two Anubites to move around now, so he has to start thinking about defending that. He's got a little wall here, but that's not going to do much. Anubites can still just move in straight to this location. However, Joe, no idea about that location. He's going to be searching blindly at this point. Brickhead, on the other hand, looks like he's gearing up to grab his own second town center, and he's going to be moving in from there. I would like to see a Hursa just on this location, just to be dissuading the Anubites from coming in. If we jump back over to Brickhead's perspective, he's looking around for some stuff. He's not going to find any of it, and I'm interested to see where he's running to. He's looking to try and go into this corner here, so he has an inkling that there is a hunting operation going on there, which there is, but he's going to have to run around that in order to get there. So he's parked a little bit inefficiently. As we see that, he's going to be running around. He's going to spot this location. These villagers are going to have to retreat there unless Hursa move over to this location in the meantime. That's not going to happen just yet. So, oh, has he changed his mind? It looks like he's changed his mind. He's not going to be looking to grab that location. So that's a really nice play there. Looks like Brick had assumed this forest with like cutting off this entire location, but Anomite's going to be moving in, finding this location here, going to be starting to pick off some of these villages at this point. Brickhead, on the other hand, is reacting very, very quickly, moving these villages back into the middle of his base, basically into that town center. He can move them over to this location. They're going to be totally fine under that settlement. Those Anubites going to be running around now. Herso are going to be moving back into this spot here to be defending, and these Herso are going to be moving in over here. They're not going to be able to do too much because there's enough Herso here to defend, and we see a little bit more raiding from those three raiding cavalries. That town center is now up. So Brickhead got his Tekken town center going now, and he's going to be in a great position to continue in this game, playing very, very well. And these Anubites can get out completely fine. Nice micro there from Brickhead. If you move your units to get targeted by the Anubites as they jump, they do no damage from that jump. The Anubites are very inaccurate. They can only hit stationary units with that movement. A nice maneuver you can do, if you notice that, is you grab your entire army, and then as they jump, you can hit spread formation and then Q. Like, you give it like 1 second, hit spread formation, give it 1 second, hit Q, and then they're gonna start fighting again. And the Anubites basically miss everything. It's pretty interesting, but I don't think many people will be aware of that or that quick to do it. You can put a hotkey on that though, so you can make it happen very, very easily. We are seeing these Anubites still running around doing what they can. Joe, on the other hand, finally getting some slingers out, has another Anubite here and some spearmen. This hunt location has been exhausted, so he's going to have to figure out somewhere else to go. He's got a couple of goat left in his base, but basically he's going to need to start getting a bunch of gold income now to get those that gold for the farms, because he's going to be running out of food soon. He does have a little bit of caribou here and some of those berries here, but no berries left in his base at all. So basically going to have to be thinking about grabbing those farms in order to even get to that next age. It looks like he might have just enough to get to the next age, just in terms of the goat. And then he can put a bunch of villages onto wood and then start building chariot arches and put a bunch of villages back onto gold. So he might be okay here. He does need to stop producing slingers in order to save that gold to get to the next age. But we'll see what he's going to be doing there. Guardian Anubite's going to be moving around yet again. Jumping back onto Brickhead's perspective, he's finished on that hunt location and he's moved back into his base, it looks like, over to this side of the map, grabbing his armory, looking like he's going to be going to the Heroic Age, probably through Skadi so that he doesn't have to deal with ancestors too much. But he's a little ways away. He's going to have to basically... he's grabbing hunt from his base, and these Anubites going to be moving in. Again, I'm not sure. It's really frustrating when I'm watching this one. I know all you got to do is just leave one Herso. It's what, three population? Just leave it there on your villager line, and you're going to be totally fine from these sorts of raids. It is pain in the fact that you got three less population, but it's easiest way to defend. And you don't want to be chasing them, because you can just run them around, and he's totally fine with that. So we'll see if Brickhead can work it out. There's so low villages here. What you want to do is swap these guys onto food in your base and then move them onto something else. We're looking like Brickhead's going to be going to that Heroic Age himself now. Joe's also going through Nephthys. He's got a bunch of gold, going to be able to chuck up his Migdal Stronghold straight away. I would actually love to see Joe go straight to the Mythic Age through Thoth though, and grab a bunch of Phoenix now. That would be pretty strong, because Brickhead's not got that many throwing axes. Oh, he does have a bunch of throwing axes now, actually. I take it back. It would be bad for him to do that, because Brickhead could just grab the upgrade, which gives yourself strong damage against myth units, and then Phoenix will just basically die. But anyways, Bragi coming through. So it looks like we're probably going to be seeing fast Ragnarok here. Got that third town center super early. Anubite's going to be attempting to jump into these guys at this point, but they're not going to do all too much. Looks like the Raiding Cavalry are going to be looking for something to do themselves. Brickhead's got a nice house on this back town center, so it's going to be able to see if that one goes up as well. These Anubites are going to be moving in. Joe, nice control. They're going to be moving them back out as well. We're seeing Migdal Stronghold going up on this forward location here. Very, very good there. That's going to be cutting off any sort of shenanigans through this location onto that gold mine. And we do see that these Anubites are moving, making a beeline straight for that gold mine at the moment. It looks like Brickhead's going to be moving them back, and a Herso are going to be moving over in the time being. We're seeing a Hilfort going up straight away for Briquette. So a little bit confusing here. Generally, if you're going for that fast Ragnarok, you don't want to be chucking up anything in that Heroic Age. You just spam villages as much as you can and get to that Mythic Age as fast as possible. But it looks like Oxcar getting picked off there. That's not good. Those Amipites are doing so much damage. Must be so frustrating. We're seeing a War Elephant moving in here. Battle Ball is out, though, so it's going to be able to defend here. Maybe Ancestors can come through, and there's not a lot that Brickhead can do to defend against the Ancestors. But if we jump back over to Joe's perspective, he does not have any Siege Towers out just yet. One Siege Tower is getting queued, and on auto queued though, as well as War Elephant. So there's quite a bit of Siege potential here as these Anubites are going to be moving around as much as possible. We're seeing these guys do what they can, but Priests are out. They don't have Funeral Rites, so the Battle Board is going to be able to take quite a bit of resistance there. Ancestors coming through, going to have to retreat there for Brickhead. We are seeing a Town Center going up as well, and Flaming Weapons is the option here. There's not that many units though for Brickhead, so Brickhead might not even be able to defend against this. That being said though, Flaming Weapons so strong, he may lose this Talent Center if he doesn't pick off these Siege Towers fast enough though. Looks like this fight is going in the favor of Brickhead, but using that Flaming Weapons means he's not going to be able to get Flaming Weapons onto his Ragnarok anymore. However, he's going to be able to push through here. If he can actually deal the damage that he wants to here, he might be able to pick off this location. Pick off this Migdal Stronghold will be absolutely huge. These Anubites are going to be falling very, very quickly. We do see Jarl's out as well. So Jarl's going to be able to pick off those Scorpion Man and all the Myth units. This is going huge for Brickhead at this point. Scorpion Man getting picked off. Now we're just going to push through, kill off this Migdal Stronghold. Joe has got that third Town Center up though, so he can keep booming and he's going to be fine. If we jump over to Brickhead's perspective, we do see 132 population for him. So he is able to keep pushing in here. Definitely want to make these Throwing Axemen move forward and stop taking damage from that Migdal Stronghold. The Migdal Stronghold is going to go down. It looks like that's going to go down. And if we jump over to Joe's perspective, he's got to build another Migdal Stronghold back here, but he's got no favor at the moment because he's building Scorpion Man. So he's going to have to transition into basically just Barracks units. So this is going super well for Brickhead. This play is incredible. If we are jumping back over to Brickhead's perspective, he does not have any armory upgrades coming through, but he doesn't even have Pierce armor just yet. But it looks like Brickhead's going to take that win there and retreat there. I'm not sure I like that. I think he could continue to push forward and push forward onto this gold mine and take that win. Just because his army is so strong, if Joe's only sitting at 106 population, you're sitting at 120, you want to keep fighting as much as you possibly can. But looks like this location was maybe a little bit too hard to push through, and Brickhead's going to just take that win and then try and recoup what's going on there. He's going to be running out of this gold mine soon. He has cast his... He did cast his Dwarven Mine at some point. I didn't actually see that. And we are seeing this location is getting battered down from the War Elephants. But I'm still not sure why Brickhead's not choosing to fight at this point. Maybe he's just planning to recoup his losses. He's going to be moving away from this gold mine, it looks like. Nope, not going to be moving away from this gold mine. It looks like a little bit of jockeying back and forth here. We are seeing these Siege Towers move forward again, and Brickhead basically needs to just see what he can do. We are seeing Ulfsark's moving. I love this. Ulfsark's moving into this location. Longhouse going down. All of these villages are going to get picked off by those medium Ulfsark's, and that's very, very good. Are we seeing Jarl's getting upgraded just yet? We are seeing medium Raiders coming in, or seeing medium Cavalry coming in now. That's going to make these Jarl's even stronger, and more stuff is coming. Another house going up there, and all these villages are still getting picked off. We're seeing a nice little war going in here. Preemptive war to stop any corner trade routes. Bunch of these Siege Towers coming in though. We are going to have to see these villagers move very, very quickly if he's going to be able to keep this Town Center alive. This is actually pretty crazy amounts of damage here. These Siege Towers don't die very quickly at all, and with four of them, that reaction is too slow. That Town Center is going to be falling very, very quickly. However, Brickhead should be able to defend against this fairly easy. If we jump over to Joe's perspective, Joe's only sitting at 130 population, so he's got a lot of work to do in order to pick off this. No, you don't want to be retreating. You have to fight this at some point. But he's going to be attempting to fight underneath the Hillfort Fire, I guess. He does have quite a few resources in the bank. He's spamming those Jarls at this point. Not happy with the fight, and he's actually going to be taking quite a bit of heat at this point. These Throwing Axemen need to be killing off those medium spears. The medium spears do not have that many upgrades. They only have medium spearmen, but these Jarls should be able to fight and should be able to pick off these units, and they're going to be totally fine. Need to get these villagers into the fray though. Need to be attacking those Siege Towers as fast as possible. We're seeing some Scorpion Men over here with these Chariot Archers. This is huge. This is really good play from Brickhead. As soon as you have one of these fights going on, you can send your units off to go raid your opponent, and they're not going to be able to tell where the warning bells are coming from. So they're not going to be looking at the minimap. He's going to be taking all of this damage from these chariot archers. We do see a Hursa was moving in here at this point, but there's too many chariot archers here in order to do this. These dwarves are now going to be running back to the town center, and we are seeing this is not going well for Brickhead at all. There is a wall here, but that's not going to be doing all too much. No armory upgrades coming in just yet for Brickhead. Joe doing very, very well at this point. We're seeing one battle ball coming in now. I'm going to be picking off all of these chariot archers. However, the hill fort, the town center has fallen there. Joe wants to move in now, grab this location, and then basically start putting any much more pressure onto Brickhead than he currently can do. But looks like he's sitting at a little bit of the low gold at this point. 29 villages on wood, way too many. Want to get a couple of those guys off that wood and somewhere else. We're seeing a marker going up now for Joe. So Joe's going to be wanting to sell some of that wood in order to perhaps go straight to the Mythic Age through Osiris or Thoth. Either one would be perfectly fine. Osiris in order to pick off the Battle Boar and stuff, or Thoth in order to the Meteor dislocation or this location, and it would be fine. If we jump over here and we look at this priest, he does not have funeral rites just yet, so no bonus against these battle ball. The battle ball going to be doing absolute work at this point. If we're jumping over to Brickhead's perspective, Brickhead's running low on resources. He's got no villagers on wood at this point in time, so he can't build any of those beautiful Huskarls. He has no Migdol stronghold either, so his basically only option right now is medium Ulfsark, and it's not going to be enough at this point. Joe managed to push through and do way too much damage. So he's basically just gonna be doing what he can in order to get to that. Looks like he's not going to the Mythic Age. He's choosing to, he's just run out of gold for some reason. Not sure. Oh, he's got a bunch of villages here not mining. Need to get those guys moving up. His economic upgrades does have quarries, so he should get gold income very, very quickly. He could trade all of that wood away in order to grab Osiris or Thoth, but it looks like he's just focusing on gold starving at this point. There's not really a lot of gold that he can get. Brickhead can move over here, which he is doing, which would have been the correct move a while ago, just because this location is where the fight is happening. We're seeing all of these chariot archers moving in, going to be trying to focus down some of those battle ball, but you want to get those onto the Ulfsark if you can. We are seeing just a little bit of trading in here. A couple of those chariot archers picking off the villages, but the battle ball now on the line of the chariot archers is going to be doing a lot of damage, and those minions also do have that copper shield, which is going to be very, very good in order to deal with those chariot archers. Chariot archers is going to have to get out of here now. We're still seeing no... I'm very, very confused at this point. I'm not seeing any real looking into the Mythic Age when he's got so many resources he could trade at this point. We are seeing the Pharaoh moving in now. He's going to be able to pick off some of those Battle Boar as well as more priests coming into the fray. Those Battle Boar are going to get picked off very, very quickly. Pharaoh has 17 damage, so he does a bunch of that damage. We are seeing the medium Axemen coming in as well in order to pick off those medium Ulfsark. So Axemen, super strong units against Norse. Huskarl get killed, throwing Axemen get killed, and Ulfsark get killed. So the only real answer to Axemen is Raiden Cavalry. And we see Osiris is the god of choice there for Joe. Brickhead, on the other hand, still has finished mining from this gold mine, but he has to now somehow get these units to survive onto a different location, and we are seeing him opting to go forward. I don't know if I like that. He's not going to be able to go forward at all here. These dwarves going to be moving through the chariot archer line. All of those going to get picked off, and when Joe hits that Mythic Age, it looks like Brickhead's going to tap out. There's not much he can do. He doesn't have that much economy left. He's sitting at 89 population. This town center looks like it is going to get picked off as well. More of those Ulfsark moving in now, but with Scorpion Man and Axemen here, they're going to do so much damage to the Ulfsark. The Ulfsark attempting to pick off these siege towers, but it's just not going to be all too well for him. Brickhead retreating back to his location here, and he's deciding to tap out. Says GG with the Osiris impending. A little bit too much for Brickhead to deal with there. I feel like Brickhead had this game in the bag, though. With Norse, you can't take the foot off the gas. That's the thing with Norse. Once you get your advantage, which you can get with flaming weapons, it's such a strong god power. Once you've got the advantage, you need to recognize that advantage and push through, deal the damage to your opponent's economy after you've killed off their army. You need to do something. You can't just take the win, because, I mean, you can. If Brickhead could, like, keep this town center alive and deal with the four or five siege towers on this location, he probably would have been fine. But having lost this town center, it was over. He just could not recover from that at all, especially with his gold mine. He could have moved over to this location earlier and taken less damage from that, from those chariot arches, but was not enough. I would have really been interested if Brickhead had kept pushing onto this location, if it would have worked. Feel like he had the advantage there with only two barracks from Joe up and no Migdol stronghold. Very difficult to keep production up. Then he would have been in a real difficult situation. If you enjoyed this game, please rate, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell if you want to see my videos as soon as they come out. My name's Boyd, and I'll see you guys next time.